Welcome to a little yoga class for opening the heart, for making our backs happy, and for ending a lovely day. So we're gonna take a deep inhale together and just sigh it out. Inhale. Sigh it out. All good things are three. Inhale. For your next few inhales, just sit a little bit taller with every inhale. And with the exhale, let your root connect to the ground. Let your sitting bones connect to the ground. And let everything flow into the earth that is no longer serving you. With the inhale, we get new energy from above. And with the exhale, you let go of everything that doesn't serve into the earth. Because today it's a bit of a chilly day, we're going to do a round of fire breath to start warming up our bodies. So if you're familiar with fire breath, you can just leave your hands where they are. If not so much, you may choose to place one hand on your tummy to follow the instructions a little more easily. So we'll take a relaxed inhale. And then from there, with every exhale, we pull the navel back towards our spine and exhale sharply through the nose. Let me demo that for a second. Maybe now is the time to grab a tissue. It's okay, it's part of the practice. So, medium inhale. And then on my count, exhale, exhale, exhale. Last one, exhale all the way, and then inhale all the way and hold it at the top. Get in touch with that practice. It may feel a little weird. I promise with every time it's a little easier. So let's do a second round of this. So gentle inhale and then start. Exhale, exhale, exhale. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Exhale all the way. Inhale all the way. Hold it at the very top. And exhale. Apologies, I didn't say how the inhale actually happens. The thing is, I don't want you to focus on the inhale, because the inhale happens by itself. So the only thing you ever need to focus on is the sharp exhale by pulling in your tummy. And then the inhale happens just by the fact that you relax that tummy again. So that one is completely passive. So we're gonna do a third and last round of this. Gentle inhale. And exhale. Thank you. Exhale all the way. Inhale all the way. Hold it here. And exhale. Good. With that, we're going to come onto our hands and our knees. Tabletop position. We'll do a few cat-cows to wake up our back and our hips. So inhale, let your belly sink down, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round your back, tuck your chin, tuck your tailbone. Inhale, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round your back. Inhale, reach your heart forward. Exhale, round your back. Inhale, reach. Exhale, round. Inhale, reach. Exhale, round. Inhale, reach. Last one. Exhale, round. With your next inhale, come back to neutral back position. Exhale here. And then with the inhale, bring your right arm up high to the sky. And then with the exhale, thread that right arm underneath your left arm, bring the right shoulder and right cheek to the mat. If your hips moved over to the left side, gently pull them back towards the right. And by pressing into that left hand, you can go as little or as deep into that twist as feels good to your body today. If you would like to take this pose a tiny bit further, you can take that left hand and walk the fingertips out so that that arm is straight. And that slightly changes the stretch. Keep pressing the back of the right hand into the floor. Last breath here. Exhale, walk that hand back in front of your face if you went there. And then with your next inhale, press into the left hand, bring the right arm back up to the sky. Exhale, bring it back down to the mat. Inhale, your left arm up. Exhale, bring it underneath, thread it through. Press the back of the left hand into the mat, right hand is in front of your face. Gently pull your hips back over to the left if they went out of stack. And then if you'd like to take it a bit further, walk those fingertips out in front of you until that arm is straight. And with your next inhale, bring the right hand back in front of your face. And with the exhale, press up. Inhale, reach that left arm high. Exhale, bring the hand back down. Inhale, walk both of your hands out in front of you. Hips stay over your knees, and we'll come into melting heart pose. So depending on how flexible your upper and middle back are, you may find yourself somewhere here in midair, and if that's not very comfortable, then you can always take a block or a rolled blanket underneath so you can rest your head on here. Or you can come shorter, stack your fists, and rest your head on there. If you can come further down, you may bring your elbows down and your forehead. And if more is available, try on work on straightening those arms as far as possible and bring your forehead down. If that gives you a really flat nose, that means your upper back is probably flexible enough to go a little deeper, and in that case, you can also bring your chin down.
Beautiful. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, slowly come out of the pose. And then with the exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back into downward facing dog. Maybe bend one knee at a time here, so stretch your calves alternately. I don't know if that's a word, alternately, alternating. Pull your shoulder blades wide, relax your neck. You can shake your head yes and no if that feels good. And let your heels sink towards the mat, so you get a nice stretch in the back of your legs. Stay here for two more breaths. With your next inhale, bend your knees a lot, look forward in between your hands, and with the exhale, walk it forward until you are in a forward fold. With your inhale, slowly roll up all the way to standing. Arms reach high at the end. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Inhale, reach your arms up, slide back bend if you wish. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up, hands on your shins, heart reaches forward. Exhale, fold back down. Step the right leg back, right knee comes onto the mat, untuck the back toes. We're in a low lunge. Inhale, come up onto your fingertips. And then exhale, soften that right hip crease. Two more deep breaths here. Next inhale, bring the hands back down on the mat, tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat, exhale, step the left leg back. Inhale here, exhale, lower knees, chest and chin. Stay here for two breaths. Elbows pull back towards your hips. With your next inhale, press into your hands, push yourself forward. Elbows pull back towards the hips, upper back lifts just from the muscles. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, come up onto your hands and your knees. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back into downward facing dog. One breath here. Your next inhale, lift the right leg off the mat. With the exhale, pull the knee into your chest and step it forward. Let your left knee come down onto the mat, untuck the back toes. Inhale, come up onto your fingertips. With your exhale, soften that left hip crease. One more breath here. And with your next inhale, press the hands into the mats, tuck the back toes, lift the knee off the mat, exhale, step it forward into forward fold. Inhale, come halfway up, heart reaches forward, exhale, fold back down. Inhale, come all the way to standing, arms reach high, add a slight back bend if you wish. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Inhale, reach your arms up, slide back bend if you wish. Exhale, fold forward. Inhale, come halfway up, heart reaches forward. Exhale, fold back down. Step the right leg back. This time we stay on the balls of the foot, on the ball of the foot. Inhale, your arms up, come into a high lunge. This one sometimes feels wobbly. If it does, you can always heel toe your front foot out. That way you stand a little wider. That'll make it feel more stable. Make sure that your lower abs are tight here. That's going to keep your lower back safe. Exhale, bring your hands behind you. Clasp your fingers, interlace your fingers if possible. If not, grab wrists.
And then work on opening those shoulders to whatever the extent that is possible to you. Maybe just by gently pulling backwards, maybe by working on straightening the arms. One deep breath more here. Exhale, let go of the hands. Inhale the arms up. Exhale, bring the hands back down. Left leg steps back, plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, lower knees, chest and chin. Inhale, scoot forward, baby cobra. Or a little higher if your back feels ready. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into hands and knees. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back into downward facing dog. One breath here. With your next inhale, lift the right leg off the mat. With the exhale, pull the knee to your chest and step forward. Inhale, your arms up, come into high lunge. On the other side, turns out my right side is a little more wobbly today. With every inhale, reach those fingertips up, and with every exhale, see if you can sink a little deeper. And then with your next inhale, grab your hand the other way, the way that feels slightly awkward, or grab the other wrist, whatever is in reach. And then again, gently work on opening those shoulders. You can lift your gaze if that feels good with your neck along with that. Last breath here. Exhale, release the hands. Inhale, the arms up. Exhale, step it forward into a forward fold. Inhale, come halfway up, heart reaches forward. Exhale, fold back down. Inhale, come all the way up to standing, arms reach high. Exhale, lower your hands to your heart. Good. Inhale, we'll come down into chair pose, so sit back as if you were going to sit on a chair. You want to see your toes and your feet in front of your knees and pull your arms back besides your head. Ideally, I want my arms to be right next to my ears, which right now they are not. I can feel it and I can see them on the side, but that's what we're working towards. So keep pulling those thumbs back. Also, make sure that your lower abs stay engaged here as well, because otherwise you may be bending your back too much like I was just doing. One more inhale here. Exhale, come down to forward fold. Inhale, come halfway up, heart reaches forward. Exhale, the hands come back down, step the right leg back. This time the heel comes onto the mat. Inhale, your arms up into warrior one. So in warrior one, both of your hip bones are pointing forward. We're not opening up to the side. So make sure your shoulders and your hips are square. Last inhale here. With the exhale, lower your hands to your heart. And then with another inhale, shift your weight forward. We're going to play with warrior three. Let the back leg float up. Ideally, you want your head, your shoulders, your spine and your heel to all be in one line. You can take your arms to the side if that's easier for you to balance, or you can keep them right here at the heart. And then, if you feel playful, maybe you're going to want to block for this, then we can let the left arm come down and open that leg up into half moon pose. So fingertips are on the floor or on a block. The right leg pushes towards the back of the mat. Toes are opening up to the side, maybe even pointing upward. And your right hand can stay on your hip, or if it's okay, you can straighten that arm out so your arms are in a T. And then if you'd still like a little more challenge, then try to look up and follow those right fingertips, and it's going to get very wobbly. stay here for a couple more breaths. If you want a little more challenge, you can add a bound half moon by adding a little quadricep stretch by grabbing your right foot with your right hand. Last inhale here. Exhale, step back, come back into warrior one. Good work. That was a challenging transition. Inhale here. Exhale, bring the hands back down. Step the left leg back, plank pose. Inhale here. Exhale, come down, lower knees, chest and chin. Inhale, scoot forward. Baby, medium, or full cobra. Listen to your back, what it's telling you. Exhale, come back down. Inhale, press into your hands and your knees. Exhale, tuck your toes, lift your hips up and back, downward facing dog. Two breaths here. With your next inhale, lift the right leg off the mat. With the exhale, pull the knee into your chest, and at the bottom of the exhale, step it through. Let your left heel come down onto the mat. Inhale your arms up. Warrior one. So remember, lower abs are tight. That'll keep your lower back happy. Want to see your big toe on the inside of that knee, otherwise you want to roll out that knee a little more and put more weight on the pinky toe. Last inhale here. With the exhale, lower your hands to your heart. And with another inhale, shift forward onto the front leg. Let the back leg float up. Warrior three. Feel free to take the arms to your sides. Keep pressing that left foot towards the back of the mat. Keep that leg active. With every inhale, pull the crown of your head forward and the heel towards the back. And then if you feel like playing a little, come along, reach those right fingertips down, bring your left hand onto the left hip, open that hip to the side, toes are pointing upward as far as possible, and then if that's okay, you can also straighten out that left arm and come into T arms. Half moon pose. And if you still are up for more play, then try and add that bound half moon by grabbing the left foot with your left hand. There we go, wobbles. And add a quadricep stretch. Good. Two more breaths here. Exhale, gently let go of the leg and step it back into warrior one. Man, that side was wobbly. That's the fun side, yeah. Exhale, bring your hands back down to the mat. Step it forward into a forward fold. Inhale, come halfway up, heart reaches forward. Exhale, fold back down. Inhale, come up into chair pose, because that's where we came from. Exhale, hold here. Keep two more breaths here. And exhale, bring your heart, hands to heart, come all the way up to standing. Good work. And then we're gonna open it up a little until your toes are as wide as the mat. And yes, we're gonna do a little yogi squat malasana. So let your hips sink down as far as they come down. Maybe you stop somewhere here. Maybe your heels come off wherever your body asks you to stop on your first edge. That's where you stop. We'll do five breaths here. lost count. Let's say we're at five. Last inhale here. Exhale, slowly come out of the pose. Bring your toes forward, roll up.
Good. From here, we're gonna bring our feet back together. With an inhale, bring your arms forward and come onto your tippy toes. I'm gonna hold a toe squat at the center level. Pull together the ankles. Last one to just strengthen our ankles a bit for today.
Last inhale here. And with the exhale, bring your hands down and sit back. And we're going to come into a twisted seat. So bring your right leg down. It can either be bent at the knee like this, or you can straighten out the bottom leg if that's too much for your body. Either version works. And then you take that right arm and wrap it around the knee, or you go past the knee, depending on how deep your twist goes. Bring your left arm very close behind you, close to your spine. And then with every inhale, sit up a little bit taller. And with every exhale, see if you can twist a little bit deeper. And by that twist a little bit deeper, I don't mean try to wrestle yourself deeper into the pose, but see if you can allow a softening that will allow you to go deeper in the twist. If your neck is okay with it, you can look over your left shoulder. Last breath here. And come back to center and switch your legs. So if your leg was straight before, then this time the left leg is out straight, right knee is up. If your knee was bent before, maybe you want to bend it again. And then take that left arm, wrap it around the right knee. Take the right arm, place it close behind your spine. If you want deeper than the wraparound, maybe you can go past the knee. You pick your level of challenge. If you notice you're leaning to the left side and you have a lot of weight on that left sitting bone, try and let the right sitting bone sink back onto the mat as well. They both want to be equally connected. Two more breaths here. With your next inhale, slowly come out of the pose. And we're going to make our way onto our backs. Roll down, heels stay close behind your bottoms. And we'll come up into bridge pose. So with your next inhale, roll up your hips and then lift as much of your spine as you can until you're all the way up on your shoulder blades. And then if you have space underneath, you can grab the other hand, you can grab a wrist or you can interlace fingers. And then work on getting those shoulders closer together and press those arms into the mat. If those hands don't want to come together, just press your hands into the mat as is. With every inhale, see if you can lift those hips the tiniest bit higher, which has the main effect of them not sinking down. One more deep inhale here, hips a tiny bit higher.
Exhale, roll back down. One more play option. If you feel like you want to go for half wheel, here is your chance. If you're not sure what half wheel is, maybe today is not the day to try. You're always welcome to do a second bridge pose. And so for those of you who know their way with half wheel, you press your hands next to your head into the mat, fingertips are pointing towards your shoulders, and then with your inhale, you lift your hips. The ones of you who do the bridge, also with your next inhale, gently lift your hips back up. And especially if you're in half wheel, you want to reach your heart forward a lot. And whenever you want to come down, make sure you tuck your chin first and then slowly lower. That way your neck's going to stay happy. One more inhale here. And then bring your chin to your chest. And slowly lower down and come out of your bridge. Gently move your knees from left to right. It's going to help release the hips and the lower back. See if you can slowly let them sink all the way to one side and then all the way to the other side. We'll give that a few more rounds. Inhale to one side, exhale to the other side. Inhale to one side, exhale to the other side. Two more. Inhale, exhale. Inhale, first side. Exhale, second side. Good. And then bring your feet up towards the sky. Grab your ankles or the soles of your feet, whatever is in reach. And then pull down on whatever you have so those knees and your tailbone come a little closer to the earth. The most important part about this pose, happy baby pose, you pull the corners of your mouth back towards your ears, because that's a happy baby. Also, most of them don't lay still, so if you got some last wiggles you want to get out, go ahead. And stay here for two more breaths. With an exhale, bring your feet and knees together. Inhale, come up, curl into a tiny ball. Squeeze everything tight. Exhale, release everything down onto your mat. And come into your final pose, Shavasana. Lay your shoulder blades flat against the mat. Let your palms open up towards the sky if that's comfortable. Relax your forehead. Relax your eyes. Relax your jaw. Relax your shoulders, your hips, your knees, and ankles. And then let your breath wash over you, fall into the back of your body. And just be for a few moments. your next inhale, come back into your body. Invite some gentle movement, breathe a little deeper. And then pull your knees into your chest. And slowly roll over onto your side. Stay here for a moment longer just to feel how you're nurtured, you're cared for, and you're loved. With your next inhale, slowly come back up into a seated position. And check in with yourself. Your physical body, your mental body, your emotions, and your connection to that divine spark of you that we call our soul. And if you notice anything is a little better, that's what we do this practice for that connection deep inside. Thank you for joining me for this practice today. Hope to see you soon.